Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will learn how to integrate enhanced input in Unreal Engine 5 to your project. So first you have to search for enhanced input from your plugins menu and make sure that it is enabled. It will be off by default, so you will have to enable it and restart the editor. After restarting, go to project settings and in input, make sure you switch to the enhanced version of input and input component. So we'll select both of them. And now you're ready to use enhanced player input component. Since we switched to player input from player input to enhanced player input component, we won't be needing any of these axis mappings or action mappings. So we can completely remove them since enhanced input doesn't use them. So before we jump into C++, we will first create some assets that are required by the enhanced input component. So first we'll create a folder here and we'll call it enhanced input. You can call it whatever you want. And in there, we'll create a new input action and we'll call it move forward. We'll open it and we'll set the value to be axis 1D and we will leave the triggers and modifiers to default. We'll save it. We'll create another input action by duplicating it and call it move right, and we'll leave everything as it is. Now after creating these assets, these input actions, we need a way to assign them, we need a way to use them, right? So we'll create a new asset called a mapping context and we'll just name it default walk. You can name it whatever you want, and after opening it we'll add the two of the mappings that we created, move forward and move right. Now we need to move forward by using the W key and we need to go back using the S key. So to do that, we'll assign the W key as forward. We won't use any triggers or modifiers on this one here, and you can press S. And to make it go backwards, you need a negative number, right? So when you press W, it will be 1, that indicates the player is moving forward, and when you press, it should be negative 1, indicating the player should move backwards. So to do that, we'll assign for the S button, we'll assign a negate modifier here, which means it will invert the input axis, so 1 becomes negative 1. And we'll do the same for move right. D will be normal, and for A, we will negate it. That's it. So we have done the blueprint side and we'll save it and we'll jump right into C++. So the first thing you need to do is go to your open your build CS file, and in there we need to add enhanced input as a dependency module. So we'll just add that enhanced input. So that's the first step, and then we will go to our main character. If it's in your project, if it's in the player controller, you can do this in the player controller as well. So the first thing that you have to do is we need to assign the input context to the player. So to do that, we'll create a new U property. We'll set it to defaults only, but you can put edit anywhere or whatever you prefer. And then we'll create a new T object pointer and assign class U input mapping context as our context. So we'll just call it a walk context. And then we'll create a new private function called input internal set context. The reason why I'm doing it like this is because if you have a project where the player can enter a vehicle or a flying car or whatever it is, you can switch the context between them. So you don't have to put everything into one context and use it. Say for example, the walk context that we created can be used when the player is on the ground. And when the player enters a vehicle, like a car, you can switch the context to a vehicle context where you can have inputs for handbrake, lights, sirens, and so on. We'll implement this function. Before we actually implement it, we'll do some cleanup. First thing is just remove everything from the player input component. So we'll just remove it since we're not using the normal input component. These bind functions right here will not work. So it's better to remove them. And after that, we will do a for loop through the mapping actions, and we will automatically bind them according to the name of the function and the name of the asset. We're going to remove all this move forward, move right, turn rate, and all that functions because we don't need the float variable here. It doesn't work. So we need to change that. Either you can rename the function, but I prefer to delete it and recreate it. We will create some functions, and it's very important that you need to prefix them with new functions. So we'll create it void internal move forward, and for the parameter, what you're going to do is we need to add an input action value. So constant f input action value, and we'll pass it as a reference, and we'll just call it value. We'll do the same for move right, and we'll just name it move right. So after defining and declaring them, we will implement it. So the first thing is we'll add the move forward function. So we'll just copy this here and we'll delete it. And since value here is a structure, this is going to say it's wrong. So what you're going to do is value.get magnitude to get the value of the input action. Do the same here. And we'll do the same for move right. We implemented the move forward and move right functions. Now we need to assign them. So inside the set context, the first thing you have to do is get the mapping. So just type constant tarray f enhanced input action key mapping is what we're looking for. So action key enhanced action key mapping. Yeah, you need to add that as a header file. In context, we'll get the mapping. After that, we need to get the input component. So to do that, we will first use e enhanced input component. We'll just call it my enhanced component. We'll cast it to enhance input component from the player input component, which is right here. So we need to add the header file. Okay, that's done. And we'll just clear everything before we assign it. And then we need to do a for loop to all the mappings that we just added here. We'll just call it key mapping and just go through all the mappings. Yeah. Now inside the for loop, we will assign the mappings to these functions. So we want to assign the move forward to internal move forward and move right to internal move right. So we will create a new f name here and we'll call it function name, and we'll create f string printf. I'll create a text, and we'll first type internal underscore percentage s sign, and then we will get the key mapping dot action dot get name. So what's happening here is when it's iterating through all the mappings that's defined in default walk, it will get the name of the assets inside this mapping. So move forward, move right will be here. So when it iterates it, the first name will be move forward and then move right and so on. Since we named the functions in such a way that internal move forward, internal move right, we will add the internal underscore as a prefix to the function, to the action name. So forward, move forward will become internal move forward. Now we will assign the function name to the component. So we'll do that by my enhance component bind action. We will type key mapping dot action and e trigger event. We'll use the trigger, and then we'll cast to u object using this, and we will use the function name to string. So now we can close our editor and recompile the project and start it. Okay, so it throwed an error saying that cannot convert argument 2 from function type to void. So I think the problem is that the function name is converting to a string while it expects an F name. So just save it and we'll compile again and start. So I compiled and started the project but forgot one important step, and that is to actually assign the default context. We declared the function but we're not calling it, right? So my bad. We will just do that in setup player component. Set the internal set context to walk context, yeah, and we can start. Okay, so a project started, and when you press play and move forward, nothing happens. Why? So the problem here is, even though we have bound the action to our functions and everything, we have still not added the mapping context, this one right here, to the subsystem, that is the local player subsystem. Now to do so, we will cast our controller to a player controller, and then we will use my controller's local player to get the enhanced input local player subsystem. After that, use the subsystem to clear the mappings and add the in-context mapping with priority 0.